Hello everyone, I'm Mu Jinru from Northwestern Polytechnical University. The title of my paper is a baggage strategy based on multi-scale texture GLCMCN model for differentiating malignant from benign layers using small proven datasets. With the recent advancement of deep learning method, its application in the differentiation layers on CT has drawn wide attention. However, there are some still difficulties that limit the improvement of classification performance. First, there is a heterogeneity of tumor polyps. That is to say, different tumors have different size and shapes. Second, it's extremely hard to acquire medical images, which leads to the small datasets. To address these limitations, we proposed our method. The method uses GLCM, use the wrong CT as the input, because GLCM can describe the texture features of wrong CT. And for a given gray value, GLCM has a fixed size. Also, we propose to adopt the baggage strategy in ensemble learning aiming at the small dataset. Let me briefly introduce the data. For each sample, GLCM in 30 directions is used to describe it. Finger B is an example of how to generate a GLCM, and by using the concept of multi-scale GLCM in 30 directions can be divided into three groups. That is to say, for each individual, data one includes the GLCM in three dimensions, data two includes six, and data three includes four. This is overview our proposed framework. We use the concept of baggage strategy to randomly generate a training and a test set from the data of each scale, which we call the RTT set. We use each RTT set to train a base learner. For each scale, we trained 15 base learners. Obviously, each learner generates a classification result, which is combined with the majority voting to generate the final prediction of polyp. The structure of base learner is shown in figure C. It contains three layers of convolution and max polling, and the fully connected layers are used to obtain the feature map and finally realize the classification. The following slide is the result of our proposed model. We have achieved robust classification results. It can be said that the best AUC of classification performance is achieved as high as 96%. These are some related comparison models and their performance. This is the average classification performance of the proposed model. It shows that our model has a better performance. Let me give you a brief summary. In this paper, a model is proposed to improve classification performance on a limited data set, which shows the superiority of the advantages in learning features and combining predictions. This indicates that our study has great potential. Thank you. That's the end of my share.